Welcome to this wonderful platform. If it is your first time of stopping by or coming across this channel for the first time, you are welcome. Please, if you like what you see here, after watching, subscribe, put on your notification bell. It's very, very important because it's going to help you to know when I upload a new video. In this channel, I present to you news on daily basis on what is happening in the whole world, especially in Nigeria and in Biafra land. Yes, Abimada Biafra, I bring to you Biafra news. So before I do that, what I always do is that I analyze it and I sit down there to watch the video together with you. Then we'll come to the comment section to talk about it. Of course, everybody is entitled to his or her opinion. That is why the comment section is there for you to contribute, leave your ideas, your thoughts, your belief about the videos that you have watched. Please, as we are doing this, let us do it constructively. As we hop into today's video, remain blessed. I appreciate all of you. I appreciate your massive support in this channel.
Because I want to end all this brouhaha, all this shaking that everybody is talking about. Like we are fighting each other, we are killing each other, we are doing this, nothing like that. I want to set the record straight. By the time I am done talking, if Simon Eber have a place where he is lagging behind, he should close that lapses. Then if the US have a place where they're lagging behind, they should also close the lapses. We move forward. What all of us want is Biafra restoration, and that is what I want. I don't want to know whether you are my mentor or you are not my mentor or whatsoever. I care not to know. I will speak the truth by the power of Ndembo Nandegede. And I have touched the Inzu on my tongue 7 times. This is Edo. When you are done using Nzu, if you don't use Edo, then you don't know what you are doing. This is Edo. Edo Edo Zifeni Nemebile Mebi. I don't know what it's called in English because Edo Abola Susibo, Abola Susoibo, Asusibo Kao. Once you are done with Nzu, you must apply Edo. And where do I apply it? I apply it on my forehead that I will say the truth. And everything I say shall be truth and nothing but the truth. On my forehead. Nirum Kanne Metuya. Nekwa ni yamu Biafra. Ezo ku kanu neku. Onye ku hyo yamu hyo. Agahama ato ashe. Ni hemma. So if you are concocting any lie against me or against anybody, just remember that there are people you don't joke with. Abu Mwamili. Abu Mwamili. Nekwa ni oso oji. Alligator Pepe. Oso oji ade jiji fere. I'm going to take 7 seats of oso oji right now to speak. So those of you who doesn't believe that there are people that can tell you truth, by now, you might start believing that I don't come here to lie to you because I want you to follow me or I want you to believe me. 7 pieces of Osoji, Ufu, Mbo, Nto, Nno, Ise, Ise, Asa, Omo Biafra, Yen Neme Bomena Nakan Neme, Nenia, Odi Mpula Asa, Nakam, Nenia, Odi Mpula Asa, 7 seats, Ufu Adapuna. I have to pick it up. Let me replace it with another one. Osoja de Gigi Fele. Osoja de Atuashi. Ezo can chole wuno tata. Unkusie anakbrum. Ife ne emen yambewe. Acho amema. Nekwa niya. Ata go miya. Obo na mtukide tamo ne kbase. Nde bu nande gede. Ha joji amu. Ha be mipe. Nkukide unkwezo kubanyeri ya. Ha goziem. Ntukide anybody obo na. Mabunde ne buye bubu ase. Ne buye bubu. Ase no ase kanina tukide ha. Nde mbuna ndege de ha joji amu. Ara anana mwuzu. Tuwe do niru. Ta osu oji. Ka unu reze mmiri webutuwe. Maka mmiri bondo. Apo mwa mmiri. Some of you will not understand what I just did. What I just did now is like I take oaths before the gods of our land, Biafra. And the mother earth, that I will say, I will tell you the truth, so that the all this brouhaha, all this bodo 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 bodo, one day actually make one now do all you double for one day capi bay on. What I am doing this evening is going to go down in history, that Mazo Alezechukwu came out and speak truth about what he knows on this issue of Simon Eber being an IPOB member or not being an IPOB member. And that truth that he speaks is what is going to set me free and set each and every one of us free. First and foremost, those of you that have been following me for a very long time knew when I made a video and I said that Simon Ekpa was not an oath taker, oath member of IPOB. That was during coronavirus sit at home. That was during sit at home. Okay? I made that video and people were attacking me. I had a whole lot of attack that very day on my platform. I said that Simon Ekpa is talking about Biafra, preaching about Biafra, doing a great job, but he was not an oath member of IPOB. When I said this thing was, this is 2021. I said it 2020. Yeah, I believe 2020. During lockdown. Some of you that are following me can bear me witness. And when I say that thing, before I accuse you, or I attack you, or I say anything about you, I have done my findings. I have done my underground research. I don't just come out and talk because people are talking. I talk because I want to say the truth. And that truth is only what is going to keep me until the day that Chukwu Okabiamu will say, my son, come and rest. But before then, I will keep on saying the truth because the truth is better. There are so many forums where I am. This issue is being discussed. People are talking about Simon Ekpa. The DOS is demoralizing him. They are trashing. They are trying to trash him. They are trying to put allegation on him. They are trying to push him aside. They are trying to do this. They are trying to do that. Listen to me. And many people have contacted me since yesterday. Say, please, come and talk. Come and talk. We know you are going to say the truth. And if I come out to say the truth without swearing with this, without applying this, without using osoji and water miri to, you know, kind of take, it's like I'm taking oath. Excuse me, please. Yeah, hello?
Hello,
yes.
Hello?
Yes, hello, I can hear you. Unelu Geba. Eh?
Hello?
Unelu Geba Ebon Naga. Unelu Geba Naga. Nah, I don't like it when I am talking and people are interrupting me. And this is a very important call. It is a very, very, very important call. Dear friends, please, I'm sorry. Let me settle this case and I will continue. Because I will not lie to you. After today, those of you that doesn't know this, the situation of things, we know. Let me just settle this call, please. I beg of you. Asimunelugebun Naga. Okay. So bad. Because I'm online. I'm live. I'm not watching you. Thank you. Bye-bye. Sorry about that. Please, my brothers and my sisters. I may not like you. Or I may not like what you are doing. It does not mean that I hate everything about you. Maybe something I don't like about you. And that thing, I may like to correct you, then you take correction. You may not like me, you may not like everything I'm doing, but there may be something I may be doing that you don't like. You right to correct me. It is left for me to take correction or not. Therefore, what I'm talking about is this. When I made that video, people were attacking me. But that video I made was correct. It was right. Because as of then, I made my findings that Mazi Ekpa have not taken any oath in IPOB. There comes a time when Mazi Nnamdi Kanu is still alive. And he will come out to watch every of my video. That is why I'm not going to pull any of my video down. No matter how threatening you. No matter how much you threaten me. Or no matter how much you beg me. Because some people are begging that you pull some of my videos. That I said no. I will keep it for record purposes. Record this video. Save this video. There comes a time when I was speaking with Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. And the issue of Simon Ekpa rose. I told him, Mazi, Simon is doing a great job. But from my findings, he is not yet an oath taker, an oath member of IPOB. Please, can you use your power to direct him and ask him to take oath so that if he's doing this, his position and everything, then it will be in line. And Biafrans will wholeheartedly welcome him. Then myself, I will feel free to talk with him. Mazi said, okay, that he's going to do that. That settles it. I did not talk about him again. I did not make mention of him more than once on my program. That once I spoke about him, and Mazi said he's going to talk to him, he's going to do something about it, because the guy is doing something great. You can't take it away from him. Your envy or jealousy cannot take away that Mazi. Your envy, somebody was calling me while I'm live. Your envy and jealousy cannot take it away from Mazi Epa, that he's doing a great job. It can never take it away from him. It doesn't matter whether you like him or not. He is doing a great job. But my concern was that whoever that is not, excuse me, animal life now. Hello?
Hello?
Okay, I'll call you back. Sorry for that interruption, please. So, like I'm saying before, I was interrupted. I don't want any situation whereby somebody will take, because you don't like somebody or you don't like somebody's attitude, you condemn what the person is doing in totality. It is wrong. So for me, I like what he was doing and what he's doing. And that is why I call the attention of our leader, that people are saying that this guy is not an oath member. Please, can you address it? And our leader say, okay. And since then, I move on. I never insult him. I never spoke about him. I never attack him. You guys are following me now. You know, I don't do that. Until recently. When he interviewed our leader, Mazen Nnamdi Kanu. The day that Simon Ekpa conducted interview with Mazen Nnamdi Kanu and Cho Ayaba, the leader, the deputy leader of Ambazonia movement, because he's not the leader, their leader is in the prison, the deputy, the person who is representing them today, Cho Ayaba. I was surprised to see that it was Simon that conducted this event. I said, well, if our leader can allow Simon Ekpa to conduct this event, maybe he have taken oath. I don't know. This is my own. I don't know. Maybe he have taken oath. Because I know our leader cannot allow Simon Ekpa to conduct such a great interview, or should I say press conference, if he is not an oath taker of this movement. Whatever you think that you are saying, you can say it for yourself. Some people will say, maybe you want to come and talk this because of that. I don't care. What I'm saying is the truth, because I have sworn. And no, all the people that are going to attack me after this program cannot use Nzu Edo. They know fit. That is me. So, after that interview, I went on and asked questions. Does it mean that Ekpa have taken oaths? That is the question I begin to ask. I begin to do my research. Does it mean that they have taken oaths? Because the Mazen Nnamdi Kanu I know cannot, I repeat, cannot allow anybody who is not under oath to conduct such, that is fighting for IPOB movement, cannot, you know, conduct such a great interview. Dele Momodu is a Yoruba man. He's not part and parcel of what we are doing. He's not a member of IPOB. He's not a Biafran. He is just a journalist. He can interview Mazen Nnamdi Kanu on a neutral ground, no shaking. Masanga, Dr. Masanga, is a freelancer. He has his own platform. He can interview Mazen Nnamdi Kanu. There's no problem. BBC Igbo, all these platforms can do that. But in as much as you are in this struggle, fighting Biafrans are listening to you and following you, and you are calling IPOB one family, Mazen Nnamdi Kanu, your leader, you must be under oath for you to do some certain things. I took my oath. I came back again. I took my oath in Arochukwu. I'm proud to say that. And I took a personal oath to stand with Mazen Nnamdi Kanu, both in life and in death. And I can never deviate. So If Simon Ekpa conducted such interview to Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, my belief was that he had taken oath. And I didn't talk about it. I begin to do my research on the ground. Because the problem we have is that Onemainu from Ayechewaka, some of our people doesn't make investigation. They don't ask questions. They don't ask questions at all. Once they hear something, bam, they grab it. They don't want to investigate whether what you're saying is truth or false. And that is why I swore right now before I begin to talk. And I'm not going to deceive you. I'm not going to lie to you. I have never disobeyed anybody in this struggle. But there is something that in me that is disobeying some others, which is truth, that is trying to be intimidated or trying to be hidden. That spirit of truth in me is going to say no, not me. Therefore, after that interview, I begin to make my research. I make my research back to where Simon Ekpa is residing, which is Finland. I heard that he have not taken oath in the family in Finland. Listen, my brothers and my sisters, I'm saying what I know. Then you take it home, you digress it, you digest it. I came to understand that he have not taken oath in Finland as a family member. Then that gave me more serious concern to know why our leader allowed him to conduct that interview. I did not ask our leader. I have my reasons. I have to approach Ekpa himself. Biafrans, listen to me. Ekpa is alive. He's watching this program. I know he's watching. If he's not watching it now, he's going to watch it later. I can't lie against a living person. Even I can't even lie against the dead. How much more the living? So, I approach Ekpa. I say, Mazi, I want to ask you something. He said, yes. I say, I want to know, have you taken oath in this struggle? Are you an oath taker? Because you conducted an interview, and that is months after he conducted that interview to Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. I say, are you an oath member? Because I didn't tell him that I have made research behind him from Finland, and the result I got from Finland says otherwise, that he is not an oath taker in Finland family. I want you to balance it with information you have outside to know who is saying the truth and who is lying, and to know, to clarify some things here. Ekpa told me, Mazi, before I conducted that interview, you see, I took oath. That is why Mazi allowed me to conduct that interview, because that is one of his conditions. I said, okay. Are you telling me in confidence, in truth and honesty, that before you did that interview, you took oath? He said, yes. Me, out of curiosity, because I want to know everything so that when I will speak, or when, I don't even know that something of this nature is going to come up today. I don't know. And that is why when I'm asking questions, I ask deep questions. That when I'm speaking truth, I will stand on that question and information I have to speak. He said he took oath. Then I asked him, who administered this oath to you? Biafrans, listen. Ekpa, you may be offended that I'm saying the truth that I know. But when I am done with my analysis, you will take something out of it. This is not a social media saga. We all met in social media. We all came together in social media. We all converged together in social media. Social media brought all of us together. So some of you who are saying, hey, they are watching their dating links on social media. They are talking on social media. They are exposing themselves on social media. Shut up. Without social media, you will not know me. Without social media, I will not know you. Without social media, I will not listen. I will not hear from Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. Without social media, I will not know about IPOB. Without social media, I will not be doing what I'm doing. Without social media, this struggle will not get to where it is. So all of us are the product of social media listeners. Don't misinterpret me. Take my word for it, for what it stands for and the true meaning. Papa told me, I asked him, who administered this oath to you? He told me in truth and honesty that it was Adama Brown that administered the oath to him. Because I know that members of DOS are watching this program. I'm seeing so many of them, they are watching. Because I cannot lie against you. And I cannot lie against Ekpa. And I cannot lie against our leader. Neither will I lie against myself. I have taken the biggest swear to speak the truth, and I must say this, the truth. So it may offend anybody. Why I'm talking like this is at the end of this program, that Ekpa should take something out of it. Then the members of the US should take something out of it. I told Ekpa, Ekpa told me that it was Adama Brown. Adama Brown is the mother of the secretary of Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, Uche Nnukori Afor. Dear friends, are you listening to me? And Adama Brown, as at the time she administered this oath to Simon Ekpa, to my knowledge, I don't believe she is a coordinator. I don't know if she's a coordinator. It is Biafrans who knows her well may say maybe she's a coordinator. But I know she was holding a post in IPOB as at that time, which the oath was later taken away from her. IPOB, President Chukwu Bike Mazo Palezada Atua Shiabu Mwachineka Abu Meze Mwife. Ebu Mwabu Wene Ukuya. Adema Atua Shi Ezeku Kanine Uku. Ezeku Bundo. So Ekpa told me it was Adama Brown that administered oath to him. Then what came into my mind is, if Adama Brown administered oath to you and it was okay to Onyen Duma Asin Nnamdi Kanu, who am I to query it?
Thank you for always watching Linda's TV show. I will see you again in my next video. Remain blessed. I appreciate each and every one of you, and keep on watching Linda's TV show. If you have not yet subscribed, please